Hi, welcome to Programming with Mesh. In this session, we will check the difference between Expo CLI and React Native CLI and create our first app with Expo. So, in the previous video, we found out what React Native is and how it works. Now, let's get started by building our first React Native app. If you search for React Native, you will find the official page. Here, click on Get Started and select Setting up the development environment from left side. For Create First React Native app, we actually have two options here. You have the Expo CLI Quick Start and the React Native CLI Quick Start. Now let's look at the differences and we will see how to create an app with both methods. Expo is a third-party service which is completely free to use. You don't need to sign up to get started and you don't have to pay to build an app. Expo gives you a managed app development workflow and makes it easier and less complicated for you to build a React Native app. The main advantage of using Expo is that you can get many native features, like accessing the camera, location, notifications, sensors, with the out-of-the-box setup. Expo also gives the added convenience of having a dedicated mobile app in both Android and iOS, which can be used to preview the built app without having to use Android Studio or Xcode. But you can't add custom native code to an Expo project, and you're limited to the Expo ecosystem. Let's look at that other workflow, the React Native CLI, that's managed by React Native team and the open source community. And there you have a bare-bone development setup, which means you get a native app. You need to install Android Studio and Xcode to build a native app, and you need to configure and manage a lot on your own. But of course, the advantage would be that you have full control. You can easily write your own native Android and iOS code and connect this to your JavaScript code. That's not really possible with Expo. Creating an app with React Native CLI is a bit more complicated, but instead gives you more advanced features. If you are getting started or if you are building a normal app, then the Expo CLI will give you everything you need. And if you need more control, then you can always switch or eject from the Expo workflow to the native workflow. In this session, we will explain how to create an app with Expo, and in the next session, we will work with React Native CLI to get acquainted with both methods. We are at the beginning of this amazing tutorial series. If you don't want to miss the next session, subscribe right now and click on the bell next to it to be the first to see these videos. So go to the expo.io. Here we see how the Expo works. In this section, you will see a simple code and next to it, you will see the output of this code. If you change the output text, we will see the result immediately on the right. We saw the result in the web output. Now we change it to Android to show us the result in an Android emulator. As you can see, the same output was displayed in the environment of an Android phone. And if I exit the app, you can see this emulator. Now we change the environment to iOS. If you don't upgrade your account at Expo, you will have to wait a while to use its internal emulators. So we see the same result in the iOS emulator. One of the biggest advantages of Expo is that you can test the app on a real device. To do this, you need to scan the generated QR code with Expo app. From this section, we can find the Expo app. Android app on Google Play, and iOS app on the App Store. After installing the Expo app on the real device, we scan this QR code with that app to see the result on our device. Now we click on Get Started to see how to create a project with Expo. We have to use NPM or Node Package Manager to install Expo, so the latest version of Node.js must be installed on our system. To install it, go to nodejs.org. There your operating system will be automatically detected, and the appropriate version with that operating system will be offered to you. Between these two versions, I suggest you install the LTS version, which is the latest stable version. So we will download and install it. To find out if it's installed correctly, open the CMD and enter node-v command. As you can see, the version shown is the same as the version we installed, and the node is installed correctly on our system. Now we continue the installation. Let me zoom in a little to make it easier to see. So using this command, we will install Expo on our system. Open the CMD or terminal and enter this command. Let it install completely. This will take some time. Expo installation is complete. Now we copy this command and run it in the folder where we want to create the app. I use Visual Studio Code in this tutorial. Open this editor in a desired folder, and from this part, open the terminal and execute the command. It asks us to select the desired template, and we select the blank here to create an empty project for us. So the project was created successfully. The project was installed by default with yarn, so we use yarn commands to execute it. Yarn start opens the Expo web page for us, and from there we can choose what happens. While yarn Android, yarn iOS, and yarn web each run the app on their own platform. So first we go to the created project folder with the cd command. And for a more comprehensive review, we run yarn start. The browser screen automatically opens for us and shows the Expo environment. From the left, we can choose in which environment the app will run. Or by scanning the QR code described earlier, we can run the app on a real device. For example, we run the app in Android emulator. I already opened an Android emulator to see the app on it. I will explain how the emulator works in the next sessions. It takes a while for the app to install on the emulator. If the execution fails, try again. Now we run the app on the web. The app will run in a new tab. Let's make some changes in the app to see the change in the output. Go to the app.js file and change the content of the text. The app is automatically refreshed and our change is applied to it. So there we go, that is your first app creation. So in the next video, let's using React Native CLI and create a React Native app that we can also use native codes in it. Now, if you do enjoy the video, please don't forget to share, subscribe, and like. And I'll see you in the next tutorial.